All right, today's adventure is a double unboxing. You've already seen the title, but the Arken EP5, 5x25x56 scope, and the new Swampfox Warhawk. I've been waiting on this thing for like 2 years. We're gonna go ahead and do a quick unboxing and get these just a first look at it. I'm tired. We did a road trip. We took one of my daughters, my youngest, my baby girl, to college, dropped her off at college and with her car and flew back. And so this week's been pretty crazy. So forgive me if I ramble. Forgive me if I step on some toes or step on my tongue, put my foot in my mouth, because I am pretty tired, but I'm gonna go ahead and knock this out. I got some rings. I got the Halo rings from Arken, but this did not come with the scope. I will tell you, so when you do buy an Arken scope, you have the option of buying a tactical pack, and I can't remember the exact name of it. Rex, Tibosaurus Rex has a code, and you can get this pretty cheap, but it includes a throw lever, it includes a bubble level, it includes this gimmick bag, if you use it, but these are pretty good deal if you buy them using that code. So that's pretty cool. We're gonna go ahead and open these up. I can tell you I have not opened these boxes. When we flew back home, they were sitting on my doorstep, so this is the first time we get to look at them. The Arken box is much sturdier. It's a harder box. I don't know if that means anything to people. Owner's manual. Sticker. I'm gonna put these out of the way so I don't get them mixed up. Okay. This looks like a tool and probably cleaning cloth, Arken little cleaning cloth. Battery. And then the scope. Okay, I'm gonna set the box aside. Comes with bikini covers. Once you take the scope off, this package is very nice. It's heavy. it's built like a tank, it seems like. But here it is in all its glory. 34 millimeter tube. This is the MRAD. Comes with a sunshade. Now I believe it was Arken. The EP4, the sunshade was really tore up. It was a different color. It didn't even match the scope. This one seems a lot better. Yeah, this one seems a lot better. I'm gonna take the sunshade off just for purposes. Okay, but here it is. Okay. That's the first one down. All right, Warhawk, long awaited, right? This is the 5x25x56 first focal plane Warhawk, 34 millimeter tube, sharpshooter mill grid, illuminated, etched glass reticle. So, sunshade. Just a normal sunshade. I really wish the companies, I know it costs more money, but I really wish they would etch the brand in there, because some brands don't play well with others. I know Vortex, my Vortex Vipers, it's etched Viper on them. It's a little bit easier when you're messing with a bunch of them. Swampfox cleaning rag, pretty cool. Oh, the honeycomb filter. That's an extra. That's kind of cool. I wasn't expecting that. Flip caps. Swampfox flip caps. There. I'll end up rolling the specs of each one. I'm not going to read them off. Manual for the sharpshooter's grid, and then the actual Warhawk manual. And then Swampfox tool, throw lever, and the battery. Now time for the scope itself. And it's hefty too. Oh, it feels even heavier than the... This is the Warhawk. Sharp. There it is. Okay. Get this box out of there. Alright. So this is what we're looking at. And I'm just gonna throw my ruler up real quick. Looks like 15 inches. Maybe a hair more. 15 inches for the Swampfox. And the Arken, it looks like 14. Maybe a little over 14. Okay. So almost an inch difference in length. I got my wife's food scale. Let's see what these things weigh right out of the box. All right. This is the Swampfox Warhawk. 2 pounds, 5 ounces. 2 pounds, 5 ounces for the Swampfox. Wow. 2 pounds, 7.4 ounces. So even though the EP5 is 1 inch shorter, it's heavier. The Arken is 2 ounces heavier, it looks like. Interesting. Interesting. Okay, so Swampfox on 5 power. The colors are real bright. That reticle is really thin. I'm gonna bump it up to 20. Actually, I'm going to bump it to 14. The eye relief seems really good, but the eye box seems small. I don't know. I need to get on, of course, get it on a mount, but the eye box seems a little finicky. Okay, I'm going to bump this down to 5. Okay. So, Christmas tree reticle is a little bit easier to read on the Arken. The eye box seems more forgiving on the Arken at 5. Wow. Man, that eye box is awesome. You've really got to get off of the scope. Interesting. Again, this is not scientific, it's just me. Okay, I set that one on 14, so I'm going to set this one on in between 12 and 16. Nice reticle. Okay, so this, okay. Edge to edge clarity on the Arken is really good. Man. Honestly, the glass. The glass is really comparable. And the eye box at 25 is about the same. So the Arken had a little, see, to me, the Arken seemed like it had an easier or more forgiving eye box at lower power. I think there's some vultures on the very top of that cell phone tower. It's pretty funny. They are way up. Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 6 vultures on the top of that cell phone tower. That's crazy. Okay. All right, let me look at them vultures with the Arken. All right. Yep. Well, there's more now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. There's 11 vultures up there. Okay, interesting. Again, I'm not very scientific, but just my eyes. The glass quality, once you get it dialed in, focused, they're both very comparable. Edge to edge clarity. The reticles is the main difference. The 1 inch, shorter. And then 2 ounces heavier, the Arken, okay? All right, turrets. I honestly think I would give the turret markings to the Arken, the way that they're marked, 2 right, 4 right, left, double row. I think that's cool, okay? I don't know if you can hear it. Very, very tactile, as the internet world wants to say. Feels real good. Okay. Again, this is the first time, so I don't know. Stiff. I'm trying to. Am I moving the wrong thing? Yeah, man. 1, 2. Oh, that's it. Holy cow! What am I doing wrong here? Oh, they're locking. Duh. Locking. Dang, I'm stupid. Okay, not. Not as loud. Not as loud, but the feel is good. It's got a good click to it. Locking, I'm stupid. I don't know if you can hear that. Okay. Okay, seems like the top turret is a little bit louder. Yeah, it does though. Seems like the top turret's a little louder. Okay. But neither turret is as audible as the Arken. Neither Swampfox turret is as audible as the Arken. Is that a must? You know, I don't know, for some people. Now this has got zero stop for the Arken. So here we are with the Arken EP5 through the Tactacam 5.0 film through scope. I'm hoping this is picking up my voice. There's a little bit of wind outside, but we're going to try this. The vultures are gone. It's actually the next day. I'm kind of ticked off. We didn't have enough lighting after I did the desktop. And I come out today and the vultures aren't up there. So I'm not sure where they're at. But again, this is a cell phone tower. It's over 1,000 yards away. And I just want to show each scope kind of perspective on it, and kind of go through some of the settings as far as the zoom and illumination. Again, this is the Arken EP5. Right now the illumination is off and I'm on 18 power. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and bump it to 25. We're at 25. What I am going to do is kind of bring it down some just to show. There you go. Different aspects of this and colors of this cell phone tower. There you go. Okay. That's 25 power, and I'm going to go ahead and turn the illumination on. Okay, so that's one. Okay, that's off again. That's in between each click. Two, off. Three, off. Four, off. Five, off, and then six, and that's max illumination. And again, it's only the center. Let me put it on this white. It's only the center crosshair that's illuminated. Maybe if I go over to the, if you can see it or not, I'm looking through my phone and it's not really showing up, so I don't know what your, if you can see more red or not. But again, on the Arken, it's only the center X that's illuminated. Again, Arken EP5, 16 power. That archery bag is 65 yards away. 16 power. 25 power. Back it out. 20, 16, 12. 10, 8, 6, 5.
That's 5 power. Arken. This is the Swampfox Warhawk, sitting at 18, same cell tower. Swampfox Warhawk, okay. I have the parallax sitting at a little, actually it's all the way on infinity, where the parallax setting on the Arken was more towards 500 versus infinity. But this is the same cell tower. I'm going to go ahead and run through the illumination. You will notice that the illumination on the Warhawk is a lot different. The whole reticle lights up versus that small centerpiece. So I'm going to go through the numbers now. And again, these are off positions in between each number. One, off, two, off, three, off, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, and see at 10, at 10 it really jumps to where you can see it. I can see it through the screen. So I have to give the illuminated reticle to the Swampfox over the Arken. And we're not even at 12 yet. 12 is max. So this is 10. Off 11. Look at that. And again, this is at max. We got one more to go. Off 12. Look at that. I mean, there's no need for me to move it around to even find what's red, right? Like I had to do with the Arken. Okay? Very nice. Okay, there's some mirage, but I think that's about as focused in. Hopefully you're seeing the mirage. But, alright. So let me kick this up to 25. There's 25. All right. 22. And I know I'm moving my whole thing here. All right. These scopes aren't on a rifle. They're just in my hog clamp, so you have to bear with me. Okay, 18. Focused in on him, it gets. Swampfox Warhawk archery target is 65 yards. I'm going to turn the reticle off. And then we're going to zoom. Okay, 5 power. 6. All right. I guess I should set my parallax. It's about 65, right? 65. All right. 6 power. 8 power. 10. 14. 18, 22, and 25. Let me get it on the target a little more. There you go. Well, they're not on the cell tower. They're circling my pasture. All right, that's enough for this. The scope's on my hog saddle. We're using the Tactacam film through scope setup on both scopes and playing around with them. And that's kind of, and then we're looking out there at the cell towers. Again, not very scientific, but I just wanted to let people see what these scopes are looking like. You know, these are, I don't consider them high-end or top-tier scopes, but they're both running 600, almost 700 bucks, I believe. So they're not cheap by no means, and I think they're heavy duty and will work on a good precision rifle. My thoughts, reticle definitely goes to the Swampfox Warhawk. I like the reticle better. Zero stop locking turrets. I think that's a personal preference who likes what better. I did see some people complaining about the zero stop on the EP5, but again, it was only a couple people complaining, and you know how it is. A lot of people make noise when they have a complaint, but when they have good things to say, they really don't get online and brag it up too much. But the numbering I would give to the Arken. I like the numbering. The Arken is shorter. I like that, but it's heavier just by a couple ounces. The Swampfox comes with flip caps. The Arken comes with the bikini. Again, personal preference. I like flip caps. What else? Turrets, as far as the feel, I think both of them are very tactile. The Arken is a little bit more audible, and I mean just a little bit more audible. The clarity of the glass, I think both of them are on par. Honestly, I think it's almost the same glass with each one. Maybe you can see some difference in the video, but I'm not sure. But edge-to-edge clarity, I think both of them are really have done really well. And I look forward to taking them out to the range and shooting. But again, this is just an unboxing and a first look at both of them, kind of give a quick comparison. Thanks for sticking through all the mumbling and the jumbling. And hopefully I can cut this down to where it's not 2 days long. And again, thanks for watching, and I appreciate it. And see you on the next adventure. Oh yeah, you gotta do your business, don't you?